Rhodes, good to see you again.
Good to see you, Joe.
Really nice to come down to Cypress Point.
Good. Glad to have you.
This is really a beautiful area. Geez, I had no idea. You know, I know you told me how great it was down here, but, you know, to see all the ground you have here. How long have you been, you know, at Cypress Point?
We've been here about 2.5 years, so we're just about brand new. Started in May of 1985. We're real proud of it. It's something new and different on the Santee Cooper Lakes.
When I first thought, you know, Santee Cooper, I thought really all it was bass fishing. And you're telling us we're going to go for stripers and big catfish.
That's exactly right. We do. I tell you, Santee, the lakes are changing. And, of course, the bass fishing's still good, but the striper fishing's getting better and better every year, and catfishing is getting to be real popular down here.
I see swimming pools, and I see tennis courts, and in the condominiums, are they all privately owned, or how is it run?
No, we have a rental program here, and our owners own the condominiums individually, and then we rent them for them. We rent them by the day or by the week, and love to have people from all over the country come in and stay with us.
So it actually acts as a camp then, because individuals can come in.
That's right.
And stay here, do fishing, do whatever, and you can arrange
That's
all
right.
of that.
We arrange the whole thing for them. They give us one phone call. We'll arrange accommodations in the condominiums. We'll arrange a guide for them. When they get here, we can even help them pick out restaurants, all that type of thing, you know, in the area.
So who's going to be taking us fishing?
Let me introduce you to our guide. This is Don Droz.
Hello, Don. Nice to meet you.
Yep.
Good to see you.
Don's been guiding on the lake for years and years, almost since there was a lake.
Really?
Just about all my life.
And we're going to go for stripers and maybe some catfish.
We're going to try to catch some big cats. We'll start early in the morning and probably do some striper fishing to start with, and then later on try for the cats.
Good,
it
great.
Should be good.
I'm anxious.
I'm ready.
Good.
I'll stay ready.
Let's go get some fish.
Good.
So we're going to be using live bait today for these flathead catfish?
Yeah, we're going to be using live white bass and brim and large type bait fish near the bottom for the flatheads.
Now what are we going to be catching jigging like this?
Jigging, you'll catch a combination of small stripers and white bass and white perch, also called Virginia perch. Mm-hmm. The stripers we release, and the white perch and white bass we keep to use for bait.
Now we could be surprised by something a little bigger jigging with this light gear.
When these fish feed on these ledges, a lot of these flathead catfish follow them in and they feed on them. And whenever you get heavy concentrations of these small fish in the area, you normally have flathead catfish that follow them in.
It's a fun way of fishing, you know, catch your own bait and then go out and catch what you're after. Do that a lot in the ocean, and never did it, you know, for a freshwater game fish before.
Sometimes I have people that come down that we start catching bait and they don't want to go catfishing. Especially when you get some bigger white bass, pound a quarter.
Oh yeah.
It makes for a good morning fishing.
The wind's coming up a little bit, but it looks like a nice clear day, so if we can catch a few more baits here, we can go catch some catfish.
You got one, man! Okay!
Ooh, what do you got there?
Catfish!
Nice. Catfish!
What we came for.
Ooh. We're doing it, huh? Pretty
good fish.
You got one?
Yeah.
Watch it.
I'm ready. Oh, there he is!
Whoa!
Jeez, I'm all cut up. I ain't good at this. Whoa! Look at this one!
Oh,
wow. Hey! Woo! Nice fish. You got yours?
No, mine went to stump.
Oh, man, that's a nice fish.
How big is that?
He's about 12, 14. Miles.
Oh, is that a pretty fish?
Now that's what y'all came to Santee Cooper for, right there.
All right, let's get this one in the box, and we'll try to get another one bigger than that one.
All righty. What kind of spoons are these, Don?
Those are Hopkins spoons.
Hopkins?
1/8 ounce. Yeah, that spoon is made for vertical jigging, just like we're doing. That's what it's designed for, and it does a good job.
So you just let it down to the bottom and...
Right, just let it down till it's laying on the bottom and then just bounce it up off the bottom and let it fall naturally.
Got a fish on here, get rolling.
That's great, Jeff. I don't feel what a fish feels like.
I guess not.
Ooh, but there's something here. Little striker.
You want the net done?
Look at
it. Now what did he
flat in?
Did he rub it in?
He was just laying there with it.
Oh, man. I thought it was hung up. Unless maybe he grabbed it and went and did get hung up.
Yep. We'll have another for the pot. We'll have that for supper tonight.
I think my jacket up. It's getting warm now. Are we in deeper water here, Don?
Yeah, we're in about 32, 33 feet of water. What we're doing now, we're trying to catch a big fish. We ride around and look in the deeper water with the graph until we find one or two right off the bottom. And then we put down live bait close to the bottom.
So now instead of laying it like we did earlier, now it's just keeping it right off the bottom rather than laying it on the bottom. That's because we're in deeper water, or?
Yeah, basically in deeper water, we tend to fish straight down. Out in the deeper water, you do have more underwater structure. And if you cast them out on the bottom, there's too much danger of him getting around a stump before you get him back to the boat.
I noticed you see these stumps, and the water here is 30-something foot deep. Those are some pretty tall trees.
Yeah. All this was swamp before it was flooded. And most of this timber you see is cypress.
Now when a fish bites, what's gonna happen?
Okay, flatheads, when they bite, they just swim up and just catch a hold of it. They don't jerk on the rod. It'll just be a slow, steady pull as he eases down with it. And then when it gets down about water level, you stick him real hard.
So you won't see it bouncing, it's just gonna...
If it's a flathead, you won't see it bounce. Now, you may get a big blue or a garfish, and sometimes they'll shake it. But
when was that dam built?
The dam was completed right about 1940. The project was started, I think, in early 38.
And that's what created all this good fishing?
That's right. What made the fishing better was the fact that they left all of this structure in. Logs and the trees and all, there was so much of it left in the lake. They created some good habitat for your small fish and really made it what it is today.
Now were these flatheads always here?
No, the flatheads were stocked into the lake about 18 or 19 years ago. They've really become a sportsman's fish in the last few years.
Well,
they get big.
I always thought Santee Cooper was known for bass and maybe crappies, but with this kind of catfishing, with the size that you're talking about, a 20, 30 pound catfish, that's a good sized catfish.
We're seeing more and more fish in the especially the 35 to 45 pound range.
Wow.
They're fairly common now.
How long would a 40 pound catfish be?
40 pounder will be between 4 and 4.5 feet.
That's like that. Ooh. Okay, we're ready.
We're ready.
got a fish. Got a
good fish.
Good going.
Good fish.
Good going.
Good fish.
Oh, come on,
good fish.
Yeah.
I think it felt good.
He's still moving.
Pretty good fish. Yeah, pretty good fish.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! That looks pretty. Oh! That's a pretty good sized fish.
Whoa, look at the size of this thing.
Right.
Oh,
right. Oh,
woo. Oh man, what a beauty. Okay. Oh, look at the size of that one.
Oh,
right. Oh, man, is that a beauty.
Nice.
Woo.
Hey, we found that. Let's see, we got a little cat in his mouth.
Oh. Yeah. Oh man, is that, how heavy is that?
What is he, Don?
Oh, he'll probably weigh 21.
Oh, is that a gorgeous fish.
That's an Arkansas blue.
Woo, here, let me get that hook out. Oh, he's in there good.
Yeah, maybe. I'm going to think how long I can hold him.
Okay, I'll get the cooler open there for you, Doug.
All righty, ready?
Good job. Woo! That's a nice fish.
Good slick hand.
Whoa.
All right, that's great. Good.
I gotta tighten the drag up a little.
All right.
Oh my gosh, look at this. Oh, look at the bubbles. Wow, whoa. Look at the size of this. Holy cow. Oh man, this is a big fish. Oh geez. Here, let me turn them around. Let me turn them. Let me get them going. Oh, look at that. Okay. Whoa, look at that. Oh man.
You need a bigger net.
All right.
Oh. Nice.
That is pretty. Want to open that cooler there then and we'll get him in. Okay. Oh boy. Woo. Oh, is that a nice fish? Whew, let's go get another one of them.
Yeah.
Or a flathead. Right. Look at this. Oh man. Come on, fish. Oh, shoot. Oh, he's gonna take a ride in the water. Oh, look at this barracuda. Get him in the net. Get him in the net. Oh, man, look at this. Gee, Rez.
Joe Kitty.
Oh, look at the size of this thing. Whoa. Get him in the net. Okay. Wow, look at the size of this thing. Now that's a catfish. Whoa. Holy cow! Man, how big is that? Oh, look at the size of this fish! That is the biggest catfish I've ever caught. In fact, it has to be about the biggest I've ever seen. Jeez! Whoa! I can't believe that. That is a beautiful fish. Whew. Now that fills a cooler. Oh, Mr. Whiskers!
That was worth driving from Ohio, wasn't it?
Boy, I'll tell you, people at home are going to go nuts when they see fish like that.
That's nice. It looks like it's bouncing against something. Maybe a stump, maybe a fish. Check it out.
Check it.
I believe it's a fish. Hit it.
Oh, gee whiz. Wow, you sure that's a fish?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a log. You sure?
Well,
it's coming. Oh, I guess it is coming. Oh my gosh, look at this.
Getting away.
Oh, cow.
Pretty proud of this.
Yes.
This is these everything.
That, we'll take that big catfish and mount him and stick him right on there. Woo! Okay.
What a fight.
What a
first time I caught a freshwater octopus.
Woo! Oh, and then you can see up to the
I can feel it. This one's gonna catch a fish.
Sometimes these flathead bite real slow. You'll pick it up and you'll just lay there and hold it. But if you feel it, sometimes it'll feel kind of spongy.
Yeah.
They don't move much.
What do you think, Don? You think I should hit them? Or every once in a while it feels like something's there, but then again it feels like it's a stump.
You're holding tension. I can tell
by
looking at the rod. I'd go ahead and wind down on him and hit him.
Okay, here goes. Ready?
Ready.
Oh, oh, yeah. Oh, that's a fish! That is a fish! Oh, shoot. That is a good one! Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Man, are they strong. Look at that. Oh, look at the size of this one! Shoot, I got my drag loose. Okay, are you ready?
I'm ready.
I don't like that anymore. Whoa! A flathead. Look at that. God, they different looking in the blues. Oh, is he pretty. Woo! Get it.
Man, you just grabbed him like a bass.
Oh. Man, is that, how heavy is that now?
He'll weigh about 18, 17.
So what was he doing? He had it all that time.
Yeah, he was just laying there with it.
Just laying there with it. Because the line would get tight, and it loosen up and tighten, and I thought it was just the boat moving or something.
They don't move very fast when they bite. They just lay there and hold it. Nice fish.
Nice fish. Okay. I got to tighten the drag up a little.
All right.
Oh my gosh, look at this. Oh, look at the bubbles. Wow, whoa. Look at the size of this. Holy cow. Oh man, this is a big fish. Oh geez. Here, let me turn them around. Let me get them going. Oh, look at that. Okay. Whoa, look at that. Oh man.
You're getting even bigger than this.
All right. Oh.
Nice.
That is pretty.
Want to open that cooler there then, and we'll get him in.
Okay. Oh boy. Whoa. Oh, is that a nice fish? Whoo! Let's go get another one of them.
Yeah.
Or a flathead. Right. Look at it. Oh man. Come on, fish. Oh shoot. Oh, he's gonna rod in the water. Oh, look at this barracuda. Get him in the net. Get him in the net,
huh?
Oh man, look at this. Gee, Rez.
Jump in it.
Oh, look at the size of this thing. Whoa. Get him in the net. Whoa. Okay. Wow, look at the size of this thing. Now that's a catfish. Whoa. Holy cow. Man, how big is that? Oh, look at the size of this fish. That is the biggest catfish I've ever caught. In fact, it has to be about the biggest I've ever seen. Jeez. Whoa. I can't believe that. That is a beautiful fish. Whew. Now that fills a cooler. Oh, Mr. Whiskers!
That was worth driving from Ohio, wasn't it?
Boy, I'll tell you, people at home are going to go nuts when they see fish like that.
That's nice. It looks like it's bouncing against something. Maybe a stump, maybe a fish. Check it out.
Check it.
I believe it's a fish. Hit it.
Oh, gee whiz!
Whoa, you sure that's a fish?
Yeah. No, it's a loss.
You sure?
Well, it's coming.
Oh, I guess it is coming. Oh my gosh, look at this.
I'm getting nowhere.
Holy cow.
Proud of this,
dude. Woo! We'll take that big catfish and mount him and stick him right down there.
Woo! Okay.
What a fight.
What a
first time I caught a freshwater octopus.
Woo!
I was thinking you could pick up a fish.
That's
our hood
fish. I can feel it. This one's gonna catch a fish.
Tighten
up.
Look, it's getting tight now.
Yeah, it's tightening up.
Are we moving or is it?
No, the boat's not moving any.
It's sitting
still.
It's tightening it.
Sometimes these flathead bite real slow. You'll pick it up and you'll just lay there and hold it. But if you feel it, sometimes it'll feel kind of spongy.
Yeah.
They don't move much.
What do you think, Don? You think I should hit him? Or every once in a while it feels like something's there, but then again it feels like it's a stump.
You're holding tension. I can tell
yeah.
By looking at the rod. I'd go ahead and wind down on him and hit him.
Okay, here goes. Ready?
Ready.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, that's a fish! That is a fish!
Oh shoot, that is a good one!
Don't get around the stump.
Man, are they strong! Look at that! Oh, look at the size of this one!
Oh, shoot, I got my dragging.
Okay, are you ready?
I'm ready.
I don't like anymore! Whoa! A flathead! Look at that! God, they different looking in the blues. Oh, is he pretty!
Woo!
Get it? Man, you just grabbed like a bass. Oh, man, is that, how heavy is that now?
He'll weigh about 18, 17.
So what was he doing? He had it all that time.
Yeah, he was just laying there with it.
Just laying there with it. Because the line would get tight, then it would loosen up, then tighten, and I thought it was just the boat moving or something.
They don't move very fast when they bite. They just lay there and hold it. Nice fish.
Nice fish. Okay.
This is Sandy Cooper Country in South Carolina, a wonderland of rugged beauty. These are man-made lakes. The big catfish lurk among the trees long since hidden from the sun. Guides like Don Droz know these waters, and we'd like to really thank him for all his hospitality. We made some great friends here, especially Shelley and Doug Rhodes of Cypress Point. The accommodations here leave nothing to be desired. I was really impressed with this place, and I can't wait to go back.